Yeah, g'day guys, welcome to Shenke Garage. So in this episode, we're gonna talk about some workshop garage cost-saving hacks. So hopefully you get something out of the video and we'll jump straight into it. Okay, so today we're gonna talk about a few cost-saving hacks that I've sort of learnt along the way while working in the shed. So it's been a good year since this shed has been built and I've set it up and have been working in it. So yeah, I just thought I would share a few little things and hopefully save a little bit of money. So this first hack is actually really quite simple. So this is the first welder that I have bought, and being a MIG welder, it obviously takes a shielding gas. So with the gas, when I first set it up, I pretty much had it set to about 25 liters per minute. So on this gauge, there's kind of like a range for MIG, and I put it right up to the top end of that range, being 25 liters per minute. So I was just absolutely going through the gas. I think the first two bottles I went through really, really quickly, and then by the third one, I thought, well, I might dial it back and just see what the welds are like. And ever since doing that, it's made no difference at all to the welds. And I think I've got it now set to about 12 liters per minute. And yeah, there's been no change at all to the quality of the weld. So I could probably even dial it back further and then maybe just do a test weld. And then yeah, you can always put it back up if the quality's up to shit. So yeah, so I think since dialing it back, I've probably saved like a good triple the amount of gas that I would normally use. So the gas does add up after a while. So I think that is quite a beneficial cost saving idea to basically, yeah, save on gas there. So this next hack is to do with a bit of shed organization. So when this shed was built, there was heaps of lengths of this channel stuff left over. So what that is from the garage sliding roller doors. So the roller door just slides in there. So I was sort of looking at it thinking what I could do with it. And with the ribs on the side of the shed that goes all the way around, so this basically just sits in there or slots in there like that. And I was thinking, well, yeah, I could just use that for hooks and you can cut it to whatever length you need and make up hooks. So you can see here, I've just sort of made up hooks and drilled a hole in there, put a bit of all thread. And then around here, I've used it for organizing all like garden tools and stuff. So I made, you know, this hook up where the broom sits in, shovels, made one for the axe. So yeah, there's heaps of things you can do and make up various hooks to organize your shed. And the beauty of it is you can, yeah, you can move it. You can basically move it wherever you want. So yeah, I thought it was actually, yeah, really, worked out really well just to organize all my shed. So yeah, I know you can go to Bunnings and get up proper like organization hooks and stuff like that, but that's actually really quite expensive to buy all these different hooks and stuff from Bunnings. So, you know, if you can get this channel stuff, it's actually, yeah, really good. And it just slides along the ribs of the shed. So yeah, I thought it was a awesome way of organizing my shed. And yeah, so I'm pretty sure you could pick that up from any sort of roller door suppliers, or I'm not sure if Bunnings sells it, but yeah, I'm pretty sure, yeah, most garage door, roller door, shed suppliers would stock that stuff. Okay, so this next one is probably something that no one ever thinks about, but it's basically rag. So yeah, rag is very handy for working in the shed. I use it pretty much every day when I'm working in here. And you can buy it from places like Super Cheap Auto or automotive stores or whatever, but it's, you know, generally it's shit rag and it's, you know, very expensive and you don't get much rag in it. So these two bags I ended up getting from Vinnie's. So Vinnie's do like a bag of rag service. You just call them up and tell them how many bags you want and they basically deliver it the next day. So these are two 10 kilogram bags. I bought these probably a year ago and haven't even used one bag yet. So yeah, for two 10 kilogram bag of t-shirt, It was $60 to $70 delivered, I think, off the top of my head. And yeah, t-shirt is what you want. So t-shirt is absorbent and it's good for wipe and down stuff. You can get cheaper like cotton, but it's generally a lot shitter. So I recommend getting t-shirt. So another good reason also is that it just supports your local op shop or thrift store if you're in America. So obviously Vinnie's does this service. I'm not sure about Salvation Army, but yeah, if you do have a local op shop, give them a call and see if they do offer bag of rag service. And it just, yeah, employs someone to do this. So generally they hire, you know, people that are in hard times, are struggling. So it keeps them employed by, you know, giving them a job to cut up this and bag it up and deliver and stuff. So yeah, so I think it's a good way, save a bit of money and support your local op shop. Okay, so this next hack is all about F-clamps. So F-clamps are very, very handy. So I made up this welding table and I use these F-clamps all the time for basically holding in steel like so. I used them to put in panels in the one tonner. So yeah, they're very, very handy. But they can actually be quite expensive F-clamps. So I was in a tool store the other day and for metalworking F-clamps, they want like $30 for just like one of them like this size, which is quite expensive. By the time you get a whole heap of them, that can add up. So with these ones, they're off eBay. I ordered them, you know, through eBay, get them delivered, and it's roughly about $17 for two F-clamps about this size. So, which works out to be $8.50 each compared to $30 that you buy from your tool store or Bunnings or wherever. So I'm pretty sure these ones are woodworking ones because they got the little caps, plastic caps. But you can just basically pull them caps off, the plastic caps, and they're pretty much good for metalworking. And I've kept these caps just in case I ever do use them for woodworking, but yeah, I've had no issues with these while using them for metalworking. They've obviously got a rubber plastic handle and it's pretty durable. I've no issues with them melting or whatever. Yeah, they've been really, really good for the, you know, the price of them really. So I'll leave a link in the show notes to the eBay website of where I purchased these from. You know, you get various sizes. I've got all these ones over here, so you got long ones, but really only use these smaller ones. It is handy having the larger ones, but yeah, I only really use the smaller ones. So yeah, for $8 each, I think that's quite cheap for F-clamps. So this next hack is not really a cost-saving hack as such, but it is something that I think is very, very important. And with that being said, I absolutely hate when you have to go to the shops and go buy something. So yeah, if you run out of something or if you need a tool or whatever, I just absolutely hate going to the shops because it can take like an hour, 2 hours of your time when you go out to the shop, go buy something, drive back, and it's just, yeah, 2 hours can go by and it could be time spent working on your project car or whatever project you got going on. Like, so what I've found is if you can think ahead and order stuff off eBay or online, you know, there's tool stores. I've got a local tool store that deliver. So I just, you go on the website, order it, and it gets delivered like the next day. So eBay is also good. Like I've ordered, you know, body fillers, you know, paints, you know, respirator, tooling, heaps of stuff off eBay. So I found, yeah, have a good think ahead about what's coming up and order stuff 2 weeks before you start it or a week or whatever. And yeah, just be organized and it's going to be beneficial in the long run because it just means you can, you know, keep working on your project for longer. Okay, so hopefully you got something out of that video. If you do have any other hacks or suggestions, leave a comment below. Also, it might help out some other people or myself on some further hacks as well. Also, if you want to help support the channel, head over to the Shenke Garage merch store. So we got t-shirts, long sleeve t-shirts, hoodies. Yeah, there's various options there. So I'll put a link below for the Shenke Garage merch store. And yeah, also hit that like and subscribe button below. That's gonna help me grow my channel. And yeah, so apologies that this video wasn't about the one tonner. I just wanted to do something a little bit different. And also I just haven't had much time to be working on the tonner last couple of weeks. But yeah, next episode will be on the tonner. So yeah, we'll leave it with that and we'll see you next time on Shenke Garage. Cheers.